This isn't a show per se. The actresses here this evening are not playing a role. They're not pretending to be anyone but themselves. They are here only to give voice to the words of women who themselves could never be here. Writers with the Afghan Women's Writing Project. Courageous women who express themselves in the face of great risk. Women who hope their words will be heard, but who have no expectation of when or where or how they'll be heard. A few years ago, two actresses in Los Angeles publicly read and filmed some poems by Tabassum Hassal. They secreted the film back to Afghanistan. Tabassum saw it, and her life was changed. Our purpose this evening is to do the same, to give voice to the words, to film the sights and sounds, and send that film back to Afghanistan to the Writing Project in the hope others of these brave, strong writers will experience what Tabassum was able to experience. Your role is every bit as important as that of these actresses. Tabassum wrote that to see, hear her poems read was truly moving. But more, to hear, see an audience, a group of strangers applaud those words, she vowed to never lay down her pen again. So my request is this. If you hear something beautiful in any of these words, something that speaks to you, applaud. Here are Madeline Finn, Michelle Raboyo, London Reynolds, Casey Renee Richards, and Michelle Zielinski with Voices Beneath the Veil.
Hi, I'm Michelle Zielinski. This poem is by Tabassum. It's entitled Night. I was in love with you. Told you I was waiting for the wedding night. You took my hands, smiled, kissed me. I lit the candle, then felt like I was the happiest woman in the world. When I woke up, I was in your grave, and tears fell from my eyes.
Hello, I'm Casey Richards, and I will be reading I Wish I Wrote My Destiny by Tabassum Hassal. I wish I wrote my destiny with silver colors of happiness shined into my life. I wish I wrote my destiny. There was no more violence, no war, no fights and conflicts. I wish I wrote my destiny. There was no grief in my heart. If I wrote my destiny, I was never a sad human. I was never gold hidden in the river. I was happy and free.
Hi, I'm Madeline Finn, and I will be reading The Winter of My Country by Tabassum Hassal. Last night I asked the sky, "Hey, why are you dry?" Sky told me, "I am angry with you and your countrymen. They fight. They kill, they commit suicide. They are cruel, they love blood more than water. So I'm angry." I looked at the sky and I kissed her hands and told her, "Dear sky, you know what you say. I agree. But women are not cruel. Children are lovely. They love the snow. So sky, dear sky, please snow. I want to make a snow girl. I want to paint it in my writing."
Hello, I'm Michelle Raboyo. I'll be reading Subject, You Can Kill Us As You Do, You Can't Take Our Religion, from Tabassum Hassal. We tolerate the suicide attacks that kill innocents in the streets. We tolerate when we sleep hungry at night. We tolerate when we lose our family members in war. We tolerate the president and the government, you people selected for us. But we can't tolerate it if you come and take our religion. We are Muslims, yes, but I am ashamed to call myself a Muslim. I don't know Islam. I don't know the reality of Islam that is peace. I know Islam from you, from books printed by you, from your money, from your media. I wish I was a real Muslim. We are weak Muslims, but it doesn't mean that you come, capture our country, and announce Christianity. I am sure all Muslims respect other religions. We never disrespect, but we know our way. Islam is very clear. If you are a Christian, be that. But never try to come to a Muslim country and play ruler. You took everything from us, you people of foreign countries, you people who live in our country. What are you here for? Are you here to kill us? Are you here to take whatever we have? Are you here to help us? Or are you here to take our religion? If you have this target, I swear to God you will fail. Stop this policy. Leave us alone. Islam is not the face of Al-Qaeda and Taliban. Islam is not the face of doing bad things. Islam is Islam. Read it. You brought Taliban into our country. The world created Talib and Al-Qaeda to show that Islam is the religion of terror. These days, the Kabul media announced that there are churches in Kabul. There are people who invite Muslims to become Christians. They pay money, they give bread. The people are poor and they accept. This kills Muslims. And why? If you are here for this reason, we can't tolerate NATO forces anymore. You can kill us. Please use the atom bomb, but never try to do anything with our beliefs. You took everything from us. You kill our families. You threaten and bring up the Taliban, and then you announce, "We help Afghanistan." You are lying. You are lying.
I'm London Reynolds, reading When We Were Kings and Queens by Manas. When I think of my childhood, I remember the days when I was a little girl with black braided hair like goat horns. In summer, my five siblings and I would sit on a wooden bed, the huge bed my father made in the middle of the yard. First, we threw little rugs on the bed, then fought to get the best corner. The breeze was our playmate. She brushed our faces, cooled our hearts, slapped the mosquitoes and flies. Like a scented friend, it carried the aroma of flowers and wheat from farther fields. Our house, in a vast meadow with few other houses, was a little flower in a bare garden, but we didn't feel alone. God was also our neighbor. We laughed on the wooden bed, drank black tea, and played with marbles, as our white dog jumped happily, circling the bed as if it were a sacred shrine. I loved her small puppies, rolling on the dusty ground with them, swirling them around by their little paws and bursting into laughter. They were like little balls of cotton. I kissed their paws and caressed them with love. Some neighbors said, "Dogs are najis, filthy." But I treasured them. They played with us, protected our house, barking at strangers and enemies. Their yelps were small and screechy, but their wills were strong. How could anyone call them unclean? They were little angels. God wouldn't create filthy things. Sometimes we didn't have bread in the house. I was hungry, so Mother gave me a piece of dried bread and said, "Share it with the dog. she is also hungry. Her kindness reminds me of when she made okra with kachiri. We sat on the wooden bed. We ate in the moonlight. We didn't have electricity, but our hearts were bright and happy. As we laughed, our teeth shone like the stars. We named the stars to own them. My eyes, like a basket, I picked them until they escaped from my eyes and entered my heart. In my best childhood memories, we are all together. Me, my siblings, my mother, and father. We weren't yet broken by war or separated, each thrown to a corner of the earth. With free minds and happy hearts, we laughed together and adored simple things. On the wooden bed, we were kings and queens.
Happiness by Sahara H. When I look at the world, when I see my life, I notice there are many things to be happy about. I am happy about the smiles of strangers on the road. When I see them, and they smile at me. I like the sound of the river, and when I hear its flow, I feel peaceful. I touch the river, and I see how lucky I am to feel its wetness. How happy I feel when I walk around to my neighbors and see how nice they are. These are few small things that make me happy. There's so much more. So much more that brings a smile to my lips. Some of the best are the people in my life. My brave father, my kind mother, my nice sister, and my brothers. They are the heroes. I thank God for giving them to me. How lucky I am to have such a nice family. I have many loyal friends who are always there to help me. I am grateful to my God who gave me such a wonderful life.
An Afghan Mother's Pains by Shogafa A.Z. I was married as a child without father or mother, without happiness. Others marry in a grand way with much joy. Others are delighted to have a child. But I lost my child because I was a child myself. Some find happiness in a new life. I lost mine in my new life. Some shop for new clothes to buy their children. I shop for soap to wash old clothes. Some don't know which food to eat. I worry I will have nothing to feed my children. Some are excited for Eid to wear new clothes. I clean dried raisins to sell for 50 Afghani to feed 5 children. I tell my daughter, your mom is alive, but you don't have a dad. I prefer to beg than force my daughter to marry young. My story will not repeat with her. I can't give my children what they want. I see in their eyes a bleak future with no education. My hands shake when I can't buy them notebooks. My heart hurts when I can't pay for their smallest wish. People take their children to the hospital for care. Mine must tolerate the sickness until they get better or die. Others wait for their father to bring them fruits at night. My children search for their sick father to bring him home. Oh God, people dream of having children. Please forgive me that I cannot feed mine. But I believe my life will not always be filled with pain. One day my dream will come true. I will see my children in school, wearing clean clothes that I wash with a grateful smile. Today, my smile is painful, but at least I have it. Tomorrow, I will smile with true happiness.
My Mother, My Hero, by Zahra W. I was just 7 when I started English class. When it was hard, my mother encouraged me. She said to me, "Your future can only be built by your hand, not by other people or men's words. You can learn English if you work hard. One day you will show people how brave you are. In a country where men do not let women speak, where you are not allowed to walk without a man, and society says learning is bad for girls, she taught me how to speak without shame, to focus, to continue. When I was ready to learn to write, she put the pencil in my fingers, and her fingers above mine, to help me to shape the letters. When I was 9, the bomb squad came to my school to remove a bomb in front of my school. Everyone cried. I wanted to leave school. She said, "Look, my daughter, this life is difficult. Do not be scared. Many girls want to go to school but can't." When I was sad and hopeless, I took my mom's hands and she told me to stand up strong with more power. After every defeat, she told me, "Defeat makes you more powerful. Dear mother, I am lucky to have you. You open new worlds to me. You show me the meaning of life and love. I love you, my hero, and thanks."
The Garden of My Homeland, Clothed in Blood and War, by Sabira. I am a daughter who has witnessed 16 springs and the nests of beautiful swallows in those winters. In the spring, all beauty and blessings rain onto the earth, like in my father and mother's house, where it rained the blessings of God. I am a daughter who was born into a big family of unschooled parents who gave special importance to education. They provoked the flame of knowledge in their babies. I am a daughter who was born into the heart of Asia at a moment when everywhere was clothed in blood and danger and fear. My mother feared for me all the time. Every family mourned for their dear children. Guns and missiles were the voices mothers heard instead of their children's babbling. My family immigrated as refugees to neighboring lands. When we returned to our homeland, its beauty was gone. It has changed to a desolate place. Bloodshed and the sound of crying was everywhere. Friendship between people had been forgotten. I was able again to enter into the garden of education and pick some flowers. I benefited from that garden. My family praised me as I grew. Day by day, I came to understand that my homeland was sick and desolate. I knew I must help transform it. My teacher said, "You are the future. You are the gardeners of your homeland." Remembering that, I made myself a garden. I made myself a gardener, and I've learned to irrigate. In my mind, I see a beautiful homeland, one far from war. When I walk the streets of my homeland, I remember nightingales at dawn. I sing for the improvement of my homeland. I give my childhood and youth to develop my homeland, the place I call my own.
Survival, by Mina M. Time gets old. I hear your voice behind the wall. When the curtain is drawn, you surrender to a muddied world. Can you see who you are? In a prison wishing for freedom? Pain cannot relieve pain. Can you hear my voice? Who can rescue you? Can you stand? Veils are everywhere. Up in the hills, there is a way, the truth of the tulip will one day be revealed. Look at the moon. Its light illuminates your face. Listen to the wind. Your voice is there. Stand on the path and look behind. Who knows the end? You must survive.
Now I Know by Shogafa. Now I know, Mom, why you sent me to another place to study, far away from you, although I missed you. Now I know, Mom, why you cried when you lost your mother, how it feels to have no angel around. Now I know how painful it is when you don't have your mother with you. Now I understand the meaning of your tears. Now I know why you missed your mom, why you carried what she passed down to you. Now I know. Now I know why you had to be so tough, why you had to be so strong, and you've taught me well. Now I understand, Mom, your hard work. Now I know how you fought for education, how you struggled to carry love and peace in a world dedicated to hatred and warfare. You cultivated love in me, Mom. You protected me from hate. You gave me wisdom, taught me about life and death, good and bad. Now I know. And I remember your wise words. Nothing will be left except morality. Now I know you better than before. Now I know what I had and what I lost. You put a pen in my hand. You placed the blank page before me to write my own destiny. Mom, give me your hand. Give me your strength. Hold me if I should stumble on my way. Guide me if I should get lost. Now I know, Mom. Now you are here with me. So let me do for you what you have done for me. Now I know, Mom. Now you are here with me. But still I miss you. I know you are safe in a place called heaven and in a place in my heart. Now I know.
Saturn's Music by Hilla means hope. I look at the night sky, wondering about you. Are you from a far-off galaxy? I live in this wreckage that the walls can't defend. This house can't hear the music of the new year. The people of this house do not have the voice to sing anymore. Where are you, dear alien? My earth is full of blood. Are we searching for you? Every day this beautiful weather comes and goes from across the mountains, crying and telling. I haven't seen the color green of friendship, the color we lost, for so long, and I am tired of this red. Between the war and the bloody streets and the pain of our land, where are the innocent? Where is the light? At night, I watch Saturn moving above my street, incomplete and alone. You too, dear alien, are alone. If you can't come, send your smile. If you can't show your face, send your compassion. My sky says, I am tired of crying. This earth says, I am tired of crying. Where is my real world, beautiful stranger? Where are you? If someone sees you, dear alien spirit, they will ask your name and wonder where you are from. And can we touch your skin? We want to meet you, but What do you want from us? I have become just a body without a spirit. Feet can't walk, hands can't hold, ears can't hear. The sun of my sky has disappeared. Give the light back to us. Come morning, allow me to explain my wounds.
Close my eyes and smile, by Shalaji. Sometimes I close my eyes to imagine the world, to imagine a world without war, without the war that destroyed our beautiful world and tore you and me apart. The war that has been here since I opened my eyes. Sometimes I close my eyes to ignore the fear. The fear I see in your eyes. The fear that keeps you silent. The fear that makes you accept the world as it is instead of trying to change it. The fear that has been in your eyes since I first looked at them. Sometimes I close my eyes to feel the peace. The peace I was born with, but never felt in my heart. The peace that was forgotten, the unattainable peace. That is only a word. Sometimes I close my eyes to think about life. The life given to us as a gift or a blessing. The life rich with undiscovered beauties. The life that gives me the opportunity to open my eyes. Sometimes I close my eyes to realize I'm alive to smile, even if a simple smile is all I can do. I'm still here to smile because I know that peace starts with a smile.
My Twilight Wish by Hasiba. Waiting for the sunrise reminded me of my innocent wish and the pleasant silence of the night. I took a ride with my wish to the top of a fresh green hill, surrounded by the twilight and silence of the night. I found myself lying down on the grass and facing the sky. The rising moon was at its fullest. The addition of the beauty was with the sparkling stars. The cold air breeze embraced my skin so deeply. I felt it in my heart. And sensation poured out of my eyes. Was the twilight what I waited for so long? No sound heard. No existence felt. Yes, the twilight everywhere. Yes, I could feel my wish so close. Yes, I could feel the night. Yes, I could spend hours on this thought. But the soft-spoken sunrise brought me back from my innocent wish with a golden morning greeting.
Letter to the Taliban by Nahid W. I am just a little kid. You take my dream, a dream of being happy with my family. You turn my smile into crying. My family would not even kill a little bird. You have no heart, no feelings. You don't know the meaning of love. I am just a little kid. My eyes are open all night, recalling the knock on the door when you came for my dad. You destroyed my home. You bring guns, blood, graves, and war. I need my dad. I need his love. I am just a little kid.
Thank you.
Safe Home by Nazrin. Where is my safe home? I am not safe anywhere. My father abuses me. My brother scorns me. My husband disrespects me for the crime of being female. My penalty is to be hated. Hated simply for being a female. Hated for being a daughter. Hated for being a sister. Hated for being a wife. No home is safe for me. Always, I am in danger. I want a safe home, but that home will come only after my death. That home will be my grave. I will live without fear. I will sleep soundly, and I will go into darkness, safe at last.
I Say No to War by Shokriya. I am a girl. I am a girl with a pen in my hand. I write from my beloved country, Afghanistan. A country with nice weather, high mountains, hospitable and kind people. Beyond the war, there is a country, an ancient country of culture and history, like the Bamiyan Buddhas, the Friday Mosque, and the Minaret of Yam. I am proud of my country. I am proud of my country's flag of three colors, black, red, and green. One day, my country will be proud of me, despite everything that happens here. Violence against women, terrorism, the Taliban killing innocent people. Peace is not just a dream. I will build my country again. I feel optimistic. I am strong and I am confident. I'm a girl and I say no to war.
Thousands of Lights On by Shagofa AZ. The pen is a strong weapon, a force for good in this world. Guns only break us down. A fire of ignorance rages across our country, hurting everyone. See all the graves, all the blood, the sky of smoke. God is unhappy. Don't you know killing people kills the world? Find the path to humanity. Paradise walks under the feet of mothers. Help the creatures of God. Don't hurt them. We want to make peace. We are thousands of lights on. You can't hide us. We will be heard. No matter the cost, we will hold our hands and our strong pens toward peace.
Read my poems on the reddish stream of my blood. By Iman. I want to write. I want to write about my dreams which never come true, my power that has always been ignored, my voice which is never heard by this deaf universe, my rights which have never been counted, my life decisions which are always made by others. Oh, my destiny, give me an answer. What am I for in the universe? What does it mean to be an Afghan woman? I know you can't provide me with an elegant answer, so just give me the pen, the hidden pen, so I can write. That is all I'm asking for. I promise I will take revenge, but not like men, by gun, sword, and aggression. Instead, I will write. I will write even if I am warned not to touch a pen or paper. I know one thing. That they can't see that hidden pen with their blind eyes, no matter how strong their vision. My eyes will read my environment, my brain will save the details, and I will write with the hidden pen on the chambers of my heart, so that when I am caught and executed, perhaps in Ghazi Stadium like other innocent Afghan women, perhaps people can read my poems on the reddish stream of my blood. I will start writing with the hidden pen, and I know this will lead to a day when girls of this land will be able to write with chalk on chalkboards or by markers on whiteboards of the universities. And one day they will make their voice heard. Then the hidden pen will be remembered forever.
If I don't write by Roya, I asked my soul last night, what happens to you if you don't write? My soul was deep in thought. I said again, answer me, pardon me. I asked, if you don't write, what will happen? My soul's eyes were full of tears. She sat in front of me and said, I can't imagine what will happen, but I can understand when I don't write, I am like a dry river. Fishes say goodbye. I am like a thirsty tree waiting for water in a desert. I am like an orphan searching for love of parents. I am like a broken lover. I am like the blasted Kabul street full of blood. When I can't write, it is hard to say, but it is my only identity. I can't stop writing because when I can't talk, when I am very alone, I am not alone. With my writings, I write about things I can't talk about. When I write, I feel fresh. I wear my favorite dress of my desires. I sit under the tree of my thoughts, and I write and write. I stop? Maybe. When I am not able to breathe, when?
How can I hide my sorrow? By Farinaz. I am an Afghan girl, tears in my eyes, pen in hand, writing from my heart. That heart full of sorrow, pain, grief, sores. How can I hide my sorrow? No one understands me or feels my sadness. No one smooths ointment on my wounds. How can I hide the sorrow that fills me when my heart is exploding, exploding, exploding?
Eyes of my burqa. By Norwan. World is a small word from the eyes of my burqa. There is no geography. I can't see my right, nor can I turn to my left. Hot in the summer, cold in the winter. Wearing a burqa, I wear a tent that hides my beauty. My mouth is bind. I have to eat my voice. My hands are locked in a cage, sentenced to move or shake, my legs too ashamed to walk. My long burqa sweeps the dust. I don't know who I am under the tent, my heavy burqa. You can't see my pen, nor my paper under the burqa. I'm an Afghan woman writer, searching for a house of freedom.
What the Afghan Women's Writing Project Means to the Women Writers, by Roya. I took my pen to write, and at first I was afraid. What to write? About what? But this was a project to write about everything. And I took the pen. I didn't write from outside my heart. I began to write about whatever was in my heart. The writing project gave me a voice.
The project gave me courage to appear as a woman, to tell about my life, to share my pains and experiences. I wonder how big the change in my destiny is because of your work and this project. Who would trust an online class, a writing project, to change a destiny and a faith? The Writers Project gave me the power to feel I am not only a woman. It gave me a title, an Afghan woman, writer. I took the pen and I wrote, and everything changed. I learned if I stand, everyone will stand. Other women in my country will stand.
We will rise by Pakiza. We will rise like a bird in the blue sky of Afghanistan to bring peace. We will shine like a star in the dark sky of Afghanistan to bring brightness. We will rise like a sun to cover the darkness. We will stand like a stable mountain to reach our goals. We will plant like a gardener to raise our children. We will fall like a drop of rain to water our homeland. We will raise our hands to accomplish our dreams.